Storyteller is created in every single project. To access these, simply click the icon on the bottom left and then the Orders tab. You can have one or multiple orders per project. You can see that I've called this order the main order, but if I select this, I can then change this if I wish to or add a new order. To add an album to an order, you have three options. The first way is to click Add Album. If you have already designed your album in Album Designer, select that album and you can see that we have 187 images over 70 pages. Click that you want one and add the price and click Add. The second way to add your album is from the Album View tab. To access this tab, simply double click on any spread and select the icon on the bottom right. Here you will see four options and it's this option that you will see the Album View tab. As you are scrolling through your album using your left and right keys on the keyboard, you can simply click the plus button. And then from here, set the quantity and the price, then click Add. And this will add the album to the order. The third option is from the main window in Album Designer. As you can see, we are now in the design phase of the album. To add this album to the order, again, simply click the plus icon at the top, select the quantity, enter the price, and select Add. You can add your gallery to the order the same way as you do your albums, by simply clicking Add to Gallery. Select the room, select any notes, the quantity, and then add the price, and then click Add. Also, from the Gallery Designer window, you have the same plus icon on the top right here. Simply by clicking the plus, you are faced with the same options where you input the price and select Add. And this will add the gallery to the order. And the same applies from the client view, simply by clicking the plus button and going through the same steps. You can also add prints and single items to your order. To do so, simply click Add Print. And this brings up your print options. As you can see, we already have our print sizing and pricing entered into Fundy Software, and we have covered this in a separate tutorial. To add, simply click Add, or to change the quantity, you can do so in this box. To change the orientation of the print, select this icon here to turn from landscape to vertical. Once you're happy, click Add. If the reprint size had tiered pricing, you will see this here. For example, my 4x6s have tiered pricing. So you can select the tier, change the orientation, and then select Add. Additionally, the process is exactly the same when you hit the plus icon next to any print. It's also possible to add anything to your client's order. To do so, simply click Add Other. And from here, you can add anything you'd like to the order. So you can add things like coasters, add some notes, change the amount, change the price, and select Add. This will give you an option at the bottom here. To add a print to this, simply go to the image well and drag the print up into the blank space. To add a gift card to your order, simply select the icon in the lower half here and then select Add to Card. If you have already created your card in Fundy Designer, you select it from the drop-down option here. change the quantity, and set the price. Any notes, and then select add. When you have finished adding items to your order, you can view the completed order by clicking the View Order icon in the bottom right. In doing so, this will bring up the client order, which will be completed with your brand, the date, and then you can enter any client information in the top left. It's here you will see how many albums you've ordered. For example, we've ordered 3, but let's say the client has then changed their mind. You simply select the one, hit 0, and then this price will disappear. You will also see any wall art, prints, cards, and anything else you've added to the order. At the bottom, you will see the subtotal, discount and credit line, which can be turned off using the client order profile, as well as any tax and the total. Once you're happy, click save, then export to PDF.